Okay, since I recorded the first video about the computer use on Anthropic, they've now released code and details of how to do that. And in this video, I'm going to show you just a quick walkthrough of how you can get this set up, a little bit about how it works, stuff like that, as we go through it. So the docs are up for computer use. You can see there's quite a strong warning, and I will suggest at the start, probably best not to run this like on your main computer unless you're going to run a containerized version, which is what I'm going to show you in here. But there's some good things in here about how it basically works and stuff like that. You can see we're just instantiating the Anthropic client just like normal. But one of the key things that we're doing is we're passing in these tools for a computer with a display size so that it can scale where to click and stuff like that. We've got a text editor and we've also got Bash that we can use. So these are tools that they've created to be able to work with this. And we can see that they've got a nice explanation of how the computer use works in here, that Claude will decide which tool to use and then give a response back. And then you'll basically use that tool on your virtual machine to get the results out. Now, the way it works is it's doing screenshots to see what's on the screen and doing things like that. If you watch the Agent S video, one of the things that it does seem that they're lacking is they're not using any of the accessibility features or anything. They're just using display features or just using screenshots in this case. So like I mentioned before, they're heavily on, you know, emphasizing that you probably should go with a containerized version of this. Be careful if you're going to run it on your local machine. I don't suggest you start out doing like that. I could imagine that you will end up customizing containers to have exactly what you want running in them and then be able to run it as you go through that. So they've got a nice repo that they've given here with the demo code and stuff like that. So we can come in, we can see the whole idea of using it as a loop, an agentic kind of loop is key in that you want it to basically get a screenshot, send to the model, get an updated action for the tool, etc., take that action, then get a new screenshot. And that requires a loop going on in here. If we jump into this, we can also see that they've got a very specific system prompt going on in here as well. So you could, I guess, run this on sort of virtual Windows machines in the cloud. And in that case, you'd want to change the system prompt. And the other thing too is you can change the system prompt a little bit to customize it to the particular tasks that you want to use this for. If we come in here and look at the tools, we can actually see that it can take actions of key, type, mouse move, left click, drag, right click, middle click, double click. There's a whole bunch of things in there which we would expect to see. And they've got some logic in there for dealing with different screen sizes, etc. Now, coming down to show you how I'm going to use it in here, again, we've got more cautions about using a dedicated machine, using something like this. We're going to basically run it with this Docker container. So the cool thing is they've made a Docker container where you can just take your Anthropic key, put it in there, and then run this Docker container and it will access it for you. You can also do this on Bedrock and you can also do this on GCP or on Vertex AI in here. And if you are doing it on those, you will basically want to connect in to access this. Because we're doing it locally, I'm just going to use localhost 8080 in here. Okay, so I've copied over, you know, that code for setting it up with Docker in here, and you'll be able to see that, okay, I'm going to basically start off by setting the key. So I couldn't run this as a file, but I'm just going to run it in here. I'm going to kill the key, obviously, after the video. Just showing you that, okay, first off, you just want to, you know, export to set up your key for this. And then you just very simply want to run the Docker container. Now, I've already run it, so it won't need to be pulled down again. If you're running it the first time, it will actually pull down all of the Docker containers and the files needed, etc., to do this. Here we can see it's just basically starting up and going. If I come in here and look at my Docker desktop, you can see that I'm using a laptop at the moment, so I didn't have Docker on this. I've just installed it. One of the easiest ways to do that is just to go to Docker desktop. It shows me that I've basically brought in these images already, And I've just started that container. So this is the container all up and running for us to use. Now, to use it, I basically just launch localhost 8080. And sure enough, you'll see that now we've got the Claude interface set up here. And I can come in and type different things. Okay, so you can see I can do a search for something like find me the docs for Anthropic computer use. Let's see if it will do this. So it's going to start off by taking a screenshot. It's the screenshot that we've got nothing open on here. It will then decide to do something, and it will do, you know, a few different things. Okay, it's opened up Firefox in this case. Now, one of the places that it does seem to get stuck occasionally is if you've got pop-ups that it doesn't know about. I'm currently traveling in Spain. So some of the things come up in Spanish, and that seems to perhaps confuse it a little bit. Okay, so in this case, it basically hasn't found what we wanted. Let's see how it recovers from the 404. I guess I should point out that at this point that I also find it a pain to often find the Anthropic docs. I think they're not under, there's no link on the homepage to find them easily. Ah, now it's gone to docs.anthropic. Okay, so you can see that it got to the page. I found the docs, didn't find the computer use docs. And then finally we got rate limited. So it actually had to stop working because of that. Just quickly to show you, in here, you have your setup so you can change your Anthropic key, etc. You can allow it to send a number of images, or you can have a custom system prompt, etc. as you go through this and can reset it to this. Open up Bash and see how big is my hard drive. Okay, so now I'm going to try to do something that's not a browser element. And by the way, up here, you can basically toggle things on. So you could actually set up some of the things on the computer and stuff. Okay, now I'm asking it open Gedit, which is the text editor here, and write me a sonnet about Anthropic's goals. So let's see how, okay, so it's opened up the app. That we can see here. It's taking a screenshot, and we can see, sure enough, there it's writing out a little sonnet, and we've got a rate limit again there, stopping us, but let's see. Please fix the indenting so that each line of the sonnet has a new line. Okay, we can see that that didn't work out very well. But it was able to open this, was able to save it. You can see that, okay, it's decided to call it the Anthropic Sonnet and save it in there. So it's pretty interesting to look at how could we use this for various different tasks, both running sort of a local container on our machine, but also running a container in the cloud that you could imagine has access to other coded agents. And that it just pings the Anthropic one every now and then to make some decisions about things as well. All right, so I'll leave it there for the video. I'll put the links below so that you can get, you know, started with this. I may do a custom video on the Patreon about how to customize the Docker container and look at different things you could do with that. As always, if you've got any questions or comments, please put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.